you might not like this video, and I'm actually okay with that. I'm sorry about it, but I'm okay with it because I have to tell you the truth. And the truth is that, you know, you can't just go out and search real world data science projects, you know, put something on your portfolio, have it be fantastic, and then all these employers are suddenly reaching out to you. It just doesn't work that way. And so what does work instead? Well, of course, people do put projects on the resume, have it improve their portfolio, and, you know, employers may reach out to them because of that. So projects are a thing. But this perceived real-world data science project thing, well, the thing is you have to do it yourself. And I know that that's irritating. And of course, you don't have to necessarily reinvent the wheel here. Like, you don't have to just, you know, make some brand new product or project, whatever it is. If you do that, please start a company if you think that it's worth it. Like, please do that. But the vast majority of you, I'm not being insulting here, probably aren't going to invent something absolutely fantastic, nor are you trying to. Most likely, you know, you want to make a great project that is going to get employers' attention. And while you're learning, you're very welcome to look at other people's blogs and projects and improve your coding skills, improve your knowledge base, and the different domains that you might want to learn about. But when you actually want to make a specific project to improve your own portfolio, well, it's got to come from you. And I'm not sure if you guys actually mentioned him in this earlier video today or in my live stream, this guy named Clement. I can't even pronounce his last name. But basically, he got into Google off of a boot camp and a couple, like one or two really nice projects that showed his sorting and like data structure skills. So basically showing all of the sorting algorithms. I think he made that in like React or something and made it look really pretty. And then basically what happened, and since he's such a YouTube star, many, many people look up to him. And so there's so many people that ended up making his project, some of them just for fun, but some of them because he stated that, like, these are the projects that got him into Google. And then suddenly everyone thought that they would also get into Google because they did those projects. And they didn't, at least not most of them. Because, like, you can't just copy someone's project. It's not going to help unless it comes from you. Because, you know, employers will just sniff this very quickly. First of all, if you do kind of, you know, make a project that everybody knows, like something simple, like the MNIST handwritten digits or the Titanic, or, you know, I still see these projects a lot on people's portfolios. And if that's all you've got, then sure. But push as much as you can if you are applying to places to get some good projects. And the best projects by far come from, like, you being passionate about something. So try your best. I know it's difficult because we're kind of trained, especially in this field, we're kind of trained to be really academic and think about all of the theory and the skills and that type of stuff. Turn that off for a little bit and go back to thinking, hey, what do you actually like? Like, what do you care about? Is it some particular sport? Is it food? Like, some particular type or category of food? You know, do you like a category of movies or some activities or books or whatever it may be? Think about those things that you like. For me, you know, I really like rock climbing, or just climbing, not actually like outdoor crazy rock climbing where I'm risking my life. I'm not going to do that. You know, indoor rock climbing. I like video games a lot. I watch streamers on Twitch. And there's some things that I like doing, and when I'm not doing like data science like content, there's a decent chance that I'm doing something like that. And so think of those things. Think of the things that you like on social media. What are you watching? Like, why are you watching it? Why do you care about these things? And that's what's really going to form the basis of your project, at least what will make the best project. You know, I made probably still the best project I've ever done in my life because when I knew very little coding, you know, I still love Pokemon. I love the video game Pokemon. And, I spent 2 months before university working on that project, and I just made it better and better and better. And by no means did I reinvent the wheel. To be honest, like if Nintendo really wanted, they could give it a cease and desist because it was a clear clone copy of it. Now, I don't recommend doing something like that, but the whole point is that, you got to do something that you're interested in. And you also don't have to completely reinvent the wheel and just make something absolutely fantastic. Maybe it's better because it looks better, or it looks different, or it uses a different coding base. Maybe it uses Python instead of someone was using JavaScript or whatever. It doesn't have to reinvent the wheel, and it should be something that you like, because if you combine those things, then you will have the freedom to go and just keep building, keep making it better, keep making it more awesome, something that you're really happy with. And that's going to directly translate to how employers perceive you. Because firstly, like there it's it, there's a decent chance it's something kind of niche, like something particular that not a lot of people are talking about. So there's that, which will immediately catch their eye. And then if you actually made something, like if you're actually passionate about it, you probably made something really elaborate and cool and interesting, and that itself will also catch the employer's eyes. Sorry about the jump there, my camera kind of broke there. So basically, if you've got the attention of an employer from some awesome project that you're really proud of, well, that also translates really well to the next step, which is, well, the interview. And that's where I know many people in general, but I know many of you are struggling with, which is actually getting past that stage of interviews. And of course, you got to know your fundamentals. Like, I'm not going to make this a whole video about interview advice, but you got to really, really know your fundamentals. And then you have to really know your projects. You have to be able to speak about, like, hey, I ran into these problems here and I overcame that by this. And this originally my design was like this, but I actually made it like that because that ended up making more sense because I ran into this problem. And you're passionate about it. Like, it's about something that you're interested in, so you're going to be able to talk about it. So all of these things combined, it just makes a better project. It makes you understand it better. It makes you care about it more, and that employers will see that. There's also the whole like very simple concept of, firstly, you can't just copy people's stuff, and also if you were to copy someone's stuff, there's a decent chance the employer has seen it already, or they can just tell that it's not like super authentic. Okay, so I hope that helped. If that did help, please drop a like on the video. And I'm sorry if it's not the answer that you were looking for, but that's the truth. Okay, so I will see you in the next video, guys. Have a great day or evening or whatever it may be. And all right, bye bye.